In terms of the growth of IT, I think we're at a new inflection point, and it's really marked by the cloud.
Today, cloud computing continues to grow, allowing people to access information and applications on the Internet through a service rather than a direct connection to a local server. The cloud represents a massive aggregation of computer data, sometimes referred to as big data.
We call it big data because all of our smart devices, our iPads, our iPhones, our Blackberries, our computers, everything is collecting data.
Cloud computing creates new centralized abilities to store, aggregate, search for, analyze, and disseminate data. This has huge implications for privacy and society.
It all comes down to the data, doesn't it? Collecting data on consumers, not on users, and we call it big data because there's so much of it, and data really is the currency of the Internet, and it has an economic value, and there's a lot of it.
And so I see cloud computing as an opportunity to really, you know, raise the bar overall. Something as a security guy that's really scary is that you have a single point or a very small number of points of failure. And so if you could get onto the administrator machine that administers the cloud, then there's this fear that you could then, you know, pull out any data you wanted from anything that's hosted in there. That's really scary. So you know you need to build very tall fences around those access points.
The cloud is going to provide a consolidation, not just of data, and not just of data centers, but of skilled personnel. So that can actually be good for security. At the same time, one of the challenges will be that the consolidation of all that data creates a rich target for cyber criminals to go after. We need to have everyone who's managing these systems to engage in basic computer security hygiene. They have to adopt documented information security policies and make sure they're faithfully executing against them.
Cloud is neither a uniquely good thing for privacy nor a unique evil such as it is sometimes portrayed. But very, very importantly, where we take that is actually going to be the result of human decision making.
In the 10 years since Microsoft created the Trustworthy Computing Initiative, much has changed. The security development lifecycle has become a leading industry practice. Mobile computing and the Internet have transformed how we communicate. We have become more dependent on information and communication technologies. Cyber threats will continue to grow more sophisticated in their abilities to gather sensitive data, disrupt critical operations, and conduct fraud. Cybersecurity is now a top priority for many nations. Collaboration among government, citizens, and industry to improve the health of the Internet remains a key element in modern society. The next decade promises new challenges and opportunities.
When I look back on Bill's original email, one of the things that just amazes me is how well he really identified the core attributes that we had to develop in our software and services. The three core attributes were security, privacy, and reliability. And they're spot on today. Even in cloud services, people want it to be reliable, they want it to be secure, they want their information to be private. So he really did a great job of identifying what was key.
We're now thinking about issues around behavioral targeted advertising and how is my IP address and cookie data being used and who's got it and how they're being accessed to it.
The future of trustworthy computing, it stretches into the horizon. It doesn't have an end date. And this is because the landscape's always changing. There are new dynamics that come along. There are new operating environments that we need to think about from a reliability perspective. There are new ways people are using technology. So in that way, our work is never done.
And I think that what we will find within the next 10 years is that more and more entrepreneurs, individuals with incredible foresight and prescience, will develop technologies that the world cannot live without.
We, as a community, our billions on this planet, can actually make conscious decisions about this. The future is not inevitable. Now we can shape it.